but he warned, we have to be careful to avoid prejudicing any proceedings. Again, this article was written by the Irish Times, written particularly by Marie O'Halloran, and again, why are these journalists simply putting the quotes in there without actually delving into it a little bit further? Because here's what really is coming from this article, if you know how to pay attention to all of this as it's been rumbling along, rather than getting the little headline and then going, fucking bastard, I hate all the... Rather than doing that, if you actually break it down and look at it for what it is, we are being told, Fine Gael deputies and senators, including a former leader of the Fine Gael party, worked for Anglo, were top executives at Anglo. We know this is also true for the Fianna Fáil party also, okay? And it's okay that this article does mention that, but then it doesn't offer its own opinion. As a journalist, the journalists are supposed to offer their opinions too. They are supposed to do that. That's what journalism is about. It's about presenting the facts and then introducing with the facts a dialect of conversation. That's what journalism is. Something for people to talk about. And I know now that we're told, that's what the editorial is for. But no, that's not what the editorial is for. The editorial in a newspaper is to represent the values of the newspaper. The journalists who work under that umbrella are supposed to be individuals, are they not? I mean, if you cannot write from your own perspective, what the hell are you doing in journalism? Anybody can write this. Anyone can do this. Anyone at all. Anyone who knows how to write a half-decent Facebook status can do this. The people in the banks were the same people who were in government. Are they not in bed together? They must be. Laws have been broken. And Eamon Lapdog Super Mr. Chihuahua wants to have a public inquiry. And as a result of any public inquiry, whatever may come out will never be able to be used in court. Never, ever. It will never be able to be used in court. Dublin Says No this week put up a video of Brendan Howland being asked about that very same question. Regarding the statute of limitation for fraud, 6 years is that timeline. That 6 year timeline is now almost up. And now they have a special liquidator trying to find out how these tapes were leaked to the public. Because if these tapes were never leaked to the public, we wouldn't have known. And the tapes themselves, I think, are being used as a distraction. And we've seen that this week with Brendan Howland. And that particular video made famous because he tries to grab the camera from the cameraman. The journal.ie actually picked up on this. But again, they focus only on the fact that he grabs the camera. And please, will you go away from me? That's his quote. That's the only thing he had to say. Please, will you go away from me? It's not an exact quote. I can't remember it off the top of my head. But that's the gist of it. He had nothing else to say. Will you go away from me? Somebody, a member of the public, somebody who Brendan Howland works for. Please, will you go away from me? But I'm your boss. Please go away from me. If I'm in a factory and my boss comes to ask me a question about something I'm not doing right in my job, and I just turn around and go, please, will you go away from me? Do I get to keep that job? This cameraman is a taxpayer. Brendan Howland, you sleeve in, you work for that cameraman. You're supposed to answer his question. And instead, what you do is you hightail it around the corner, and then you so arrogantly click your finger to bring to the attention of the Gardaí that you are having somebody question you. And you want the Gardaí to protect you from being questioned. And then you run into this government building where you again click your finger. And a guard comes running out to the cameraman. They were the two things that the media focused on. You never focused on the fact that the cameraman was asking about the statute of limitations on fraud. And this particular group, Dublin Says No, were correct in their assertions. And the mainstream press glossed over that completely. And you, Eamon Gilmore, you're telling us that this is a good thing, and we should only have these questions brought out in the Oireachtas. We can't use that information from the Oireachtas in a court. If you want to represent the interests of the public, you should have these questions asked in front of a jury in our courts and let the people decide what should happen to these people who have broken the law. That's what you should be doing, Mr. Gilmore, and you're not. You want us to do what we done with Bertie Ahern, who also broke the law and never, ever, ever could face criminal prosecution because he did it in the Oireachtas. You want us to do that again? Spending millions of money that apparently Ireland has not got to make solicitors and barristers even more wealthier just for that one purpose of being able to avoid it having to go to court? Is it because, Mr. Gilmore, that your party would be damaged severely if it was brought to court also? Because we know for a fact Fianna Gael and Fianna Fáil would. They would be decimated by this. Never voted for again if it was brought into a criminal court. Are you worried that your party's guilty too? Is that what this is really about? And are these tapes there as a distraction to get us all really, really annoyed at a time when the banking codes of practices are brought in and the government is sponsoring and fully supporting evictions? Ireland was apparently granted freedom due to the Irish fighting back against a monarch. Because we were having our homes taken from us. We were being kicked to the street. That was the big part of everything that drove the Irish to get rid of the monarch, apparently. And now we've replaced the monarch 100 years later, almost in time for the 100-year anniversary of 1916, with the banks. And you want to do this to our country, to the people who actually were silly enough to put faith in you. And this is how you reward that vote that you got? Protect social interests. Vote Labour. That's what yous were all about. Protect children. Vote Labour. Protect child benefit. Vote Labour. Not another cent. Disgusting behaviour from these people. Disgusting. None of them should be voted for again. Not one of them. Not one of them in any of the parties. They should all be removed. Permanently, and their families removed, 100% gone, whole new system, drag it down, start again.